I was living in Mongolia for some time, and I was, you know, like teaching a little bit in Ulaanbaatar University, also studying the language. And at that time, I was working as a volunteer English teacher in this monastery, which was called Petup Monastery in Ulaanbaatar. And this boy just came in, and he wanted to enter the monastery. So, you know, when I saw the boy, it was very strange for me that he wants to be a monk, because he didn't look like a monk at all, and he was a very naughty kid. The very interesting thing was that I had a camera at that time, and I was filming just the rituals in the monastery. So I started to film him straight away, and it turned out to be quite an interesting story to follow. It was a bit more difficult to get used to the mom. She's older, and she was, you know, in Mongolia is the culture of Mongolia, you know, it's a lot about pride, about being proud of something. So, you know, and they are poor, so she was a little bit ashamed in the beginning to be filmed. But I think it all went quite fluent and relatively fast. I think in this in the character of the boy, you can see whole Mongolia. You know, it's like going between being modern and between being traditional, you know, trying to choose between being spiritual and between wanting practical things. Personally, don't believe in free will, and you know, we talk about free will like we are choosing our life, but I think the story shows very well that our social context defines what we are going to achieve in our lives. I didn't have a particular relationship with them, but the monastery manager, he was my friend, so he introduced me to everyone and he asked, so he was my gatekeeper to the monastery. But all the bigger lamas, they were just very nice, very warm people and very welcoming. I never had problems with them.